Haven't we all been during those desperate times and we have installed a dating app or logged into, you know, a dating website? Hello everyone, this is Calliopal and today we are going to discuss online dating. Yes, online dating is happening on a huge level everywhere, including in India. Otherwise, why do you think Tinder is also almost very much popular among youngsters? Though I'm not saying that the traditional ways of dating have been like, you know, hijacked by online dating. No, it is still happening. Some people still feel that, you know, online dating is very superficial and it is like, you know, more of a desperate attempt to find a potential partner, and most of the time you don't meet anyone there, you know, it's such a waste of time. So let's, you know, decipher a little bit of pros and cons of online dating and does it actually work for people, and also I'm gonna talk about my experiences when it comes to online dating. Now let me tell you that from my own experiences, like, I have been in long distance relationships. I have met people from Facebook and I have also tried using one of the popular dating websites. So my problem was not with online dating. The problem was with the people I was dating. Whether you meet people, you know, in the traditional way, like say at a bar or through friends, or whether you meet people online, it is always going to be the people who are going to disappoint you, or relationships just don't work out because of compatibility issues or whatever. The problem is not with online dating. Now, why are like dating apps and websites so popular, like, you know, these days? The thing is that some people, especially men, have told me that they use, you know, these apps or even websites for just hookups. They are not really serious about being in long-term relationships. But for a lot of people who are introverts or, you know, like who lead really busy lives, and some of them might be like, you know, they must have tried everything but they're not meeting anyone, so they just want to give it, you know, give it a shot. So these are the reasons also, like, you know, people might be actually serious about finding a potential partner and that's why they want to try. I would say that, you know, there are a lot of men on these websites compared to women. That might be also because of the imbalance of the sex ratio. Or there might be, you know, like women must be like a little cautious because there are a lot of fake profiles, and, you know, that must be like the reason, or we just wanna like stay away from the creeps. So that must be one more reason why there are a lot of men there. And, you know, so the imbalance in the numbers, you know, makes even an average looking woman also feel like, you know, she's getting a lot of attention from men. Now I would say that go for these apps like Tinder if you are looking for just hookups. You know, don't go there if you're looking for long-term relationships. It's almost like, you know, going to Pizza Hut and then ordering a salad. Doesn't make sense. Apps and websites like, you know, OkCupid, Match.com, eHarmony, and there are a couple of others also, and you can also use social media. I've heard a lot of people meet through even Instagram, so just take a chance, baby. Yes, there are a lot of questions you have to answer, but that is good, you know. Take time out when you're free, like say on a Sunday, and sit and make a proper profile, write a proper detailed information, you know, even in the profile, so that you would meet someone what you're looking for. Otherwise they send you like, you know, email of these profiles which do not kind of fit into the picture of what you're looking for. A few of the cons, if you have to see, then it will be like, you know, the amount of messages you get, especially if you are a girl. There are going to be a lot of messages you get. Some people also get a little personal. I mean, that's so not done, like, you know, I got like messages from men telling me, I have written such a long profile and good luck on finding, you know, someone with so much of whatever information I had written. Oh, I should not go for just looks. And some people attacked me, like, you know, personally, like about my looks, about my age, and a lot of things. So you have to be a little thick-skinned when it comes to online dating. I mean, I feel it's nothing different than the normal dating, because you go through rejections also. I mean, it might be possible that you like someone, you tell him, and that person might not like you. So it is okay. It's something like, it's the same when it comes to online dating. Another thing is, in our country at least, or I think it's with all the South Asian countries, you know, especially men, they cannot handle rejections. Now that is whether you are, you know, walking on the road or whether you meet someone anywhere, or even on, especially on social media and these websites, it's the same. Like, you know, if you say no, you're not interested, they are so persistent and unnecessary, they bother you. And then, you know, at the end, they might even abuse you. Some men have even offered me money. Now, you know, offered me money for sex. So that has happened even on Facebook. Now, that might also be because my profile information says that I'm an actor. So people automatically assume that all actors are sluts. We are ready to do anything. So anyway, I feel that, you know, a woman, irrespective of whatever profession, she has to deal with such people. A few tips I would like to give, you know, write a proper detailed profile so that, you know, like it mentions, like, you know, what you're looking for, short-term, long-term relationships, or you're just there for hookups, or I guess there is an option if you're looking for marriage also. I'm not sure, but there are some websites offering that. Ignore, you know, mean messages or someone really writing something really dirty. Just report them, just report their profile, or just delete the messages. Message the people you like, you know, whoever's profile you like. This includes, like, for both men and women. Like, if they like you, if they want to get to know you, they will message you, otherwise they won't. So it's okay, move on to another profile. Online dating, you know, gives a chance to get to know this person through chat, you know, before you actually meet or speak over the phone. So ask whatever you want to, like, gather a lot of information about this person. Next thing is, like, you know, talk over the phone. And then if you feel like, you know, you both are quite compatible and you feel it's safe to meet, then go ahead and meet. Like, take like at least 2 weeks time before you meet this person, and make sure you meet him or her at a public place. So, you know, choose something like a coffee shop, which is, you know, much more informal. Dress casually, you know, don't like dress up and go. It's very much possible that you might not like this person when you meet him or her. And I believe that, you know, do not like always go for that first impression. Give it some time, and still if you feel that no, you do not like this person, then it's okay. Just tell them that it's not working out and you have turned out to be something different, and you know, like, talk about it and just move on. Like, there are plenty of fishes in the sea, so it's okay. There is no need to like feel bad. Talk. Sweating. Mumbai heat. Okay, so that's what I have to say about online dating. I mean, it's no big deal. A lot of people are doing it. So you don't have to feel like, oh my god, would I look desperate? Okay, you know, this, that. Just remove that thing from your mind and just go ahead. If you ask me, I've not had like too much of success with it, but it's okay. Maybe for you people it might be different. So go ahead and take a chance if you want to. Otherwise, there are always traditional ways of meeting people. That's it, guys and girls. I hope you like the video. If you like it, please give it a thumbs up and comment below and let me know whether you have tried online dating anytime. And share with your friends. And subscribe. I still need a lot of subscribers. So if you're liking my content, please go ahead and press the subscribe button. So until next time, it's bye-bye from me. Take care.